taking the pressure off myself by guiding you back to the screen. It's an honor for me today to be speaking to you on behalf of the cohort. I'm just curious, have any of you in your bathing suit ever jumped into the deep end of a pool and not gotten wet? You got out and you were dry? You know that doesn't happen. You know that water is a totally immersive experience and that we always get wet when we jump in. It's a metaphor for me for the job process, because when you're looking for a job, you're immersed in it. I think of it as the job hunt pool. And the funny thing was, though, is we were all sitting on pool chairs, enjoying the sun, having a margarita, when someone, maybe it was self-imposed, maybe it was some entity, picked us up and threw us into the job hunt pool. The job hunt pool is vast, and it's not quite clear where to swim, and your swimming skills aren't as good as you thought they would be. And when you get tired of swimming around, treading water, putting in 200 resumes on the internet and not getting a single response, you start to look around for help. And I think that's how most of us found the LA Fellows. And the LA Fellows isn't for everyone. It's a tough process. You have to commit to it. To get to improve your stroke, to learn your values, to learn your transferable skills. But also it's even more. It's this idea of building a very strong resume. It's this idea of using networking as a way to find the hidden job market. To use informational interviews to learn more about your industry. And when it comes time for an interview, to understand how to be the candidate of choice. And the pace of the program, it's grueling. Honestly, I can hardly look up for the last 9 weeks. I think of it as climbing to the top of a water slide. As you get to the top of this water slide, you look around and you see all this opportunity. And then during the day, you're getting all these ideas and all this motivation. You're sliding down the slide. At the very end of the slide, what happens? Unceremoniously, it casts you back into the job hunt pool. Except this time, you're a little bit stronger swimmer. You're a little bit smarter, a little bit more hopeful. What the program does really effectively for me is it created kind of a bubble, a safe space, a place where all of us could work together and share in a way that we wouldn't normally share. And there is a lot of power in the idea of hearing other people's challenges, what worked for them, what didn't work for them, and opening up that way yourself. Underscoring all of this for me was this opportunity to receive help, which is hard for me to do sometimes because of my ego. And also to be able to give help to people. The program also underscores another important aspect, and this is this opportunity to get to know yourself, because you get to meet in this group of people that you haven't met with before. You get to watch how you interact with the group, how they interact with you, how you communicate, how you slowly warm up to each other, and slowly you start to learn about yourself. And as Lynette Ward's with two N's, is always, it's always so fond of saying, the more you know yourself, the easier your career work will be. For me, LA Fellows has been eye-opening. My history has been in my chosen field that I've always been able to do okay. Someone early in our cohort described it perfectly. They described it like Tarzan, swinging from vine to vine, job to job, until there were no more vines. And it was at that point, I had the skills, I had the experience, but I had zero job focus. And for me, it was more like jumping off a cruise ship and landing in the middle of the job hunt ocean. I had no idea which way to swim. There's also something a little bit bigger for me, something that I don't normally talk about, and something that is relevant to my experience in LA Fellows. And my spouse, wife, often refers to it as I changed my book cover. I transitioned from a man to a woman. Excuse me. Dang, I was unprepared.
You got this.
We love you.
And I have to say, oh yeah, that was a decision many people understood. And it was definitely not in the top five things you should do when you decide to change your career. And although I had a lot of support, it still impacted my self-confidence, it still impacted my emotional intelligence, and it gave me kind of an excuse as to why I wasn't doing more to find a job. When I came to the LA Fellows, I had two important goals. One of them was to develop clarity around my job search, that I knew what I was going to go after. And the second one was to become comfortable as Elizabeth working in a business environment. And during this 9 weeks, I have to say, I've come a long ways on both of those things. And I even landed a part-time job. Yeah. So it was good for me. But it's really clear to me the benefit of the LA Fellows program. I know that lifting each cohort takes a lot of funding. It takes a lot of effort. It takes a tribe that they've talked about. And I know what's really important to the program, and that is each cohort finding a job. Because it's in that proof, the proof of the pudding there, that the cohorts continue to exist. And I know that cohort 17 will continue to demonstrate this and provide the evidence needed to continue to support this program. And that I would love to see the cohorts go on for a long time, the 18 and 19 and 20, and that it continues to serve Americans who are challenged by their job transition. And I also want to acknowledge some people, and there's a lot of people in this program that I benefited from, but I do want to start with Mary Turner. She was the cornerstone of our program. Mary, you've been amazing. When she read my speech, she didn't want me to put this section in here, so I'm going to double embarrass you. And then there are her minions. And all the other people who were involved in the Worksource Center that made that program work. I would be remiss, though, if I also didn't include in this gratefulness the management of the Core Course Bench, which includes Doug and Allison, which I didn't get to know very well, and all the other people, because without management support, programs like this just can't exist. And then underlying this, of course, are the people who funded it, which I have no idea how that works. I don't need to know. But I can be grateful for it. Next, I want to thank the instructors. I want to thank every one of them. Lynette, Larry, Andrea, Sam, Roberto, Mary, Andrew, Lisa, Maggie, and Anthony. They shared their knowledge. They shared their skills with us. They gave us actionable ideas. But just as importantly, this is a fun group of people. Now imagine this. Larry Grayman has a theme song. And so when our first class, Larry sang us the LA Fellows theme song. And you heard Larry sing today, so you can believe that. Lynette, in our last class, she read us the Dr. Seuss book, Oh, the Places You Will Go. And Allison Mitchell, she continued to try to convince us that driving the 210 to San Bernardino was a good idea. It wasn't just their instruction, though. It was also their skill-building exercises and their creative intent. And that showed up in things like stress reduction and our drum circle. These people left no stone unturned. Finally and lastly, this talk would not be complete if I did not offer thanks to my fellow cohorts, cohort 17. I honor your commitment and your willingness to give 100% of this program. I know that each of you is going to find the right opportunity. But more importantly, we've learned how to manage our careers, our brand management, our careers, so that when inevitably we'll have to look again, we will know how to find that right opportunity again. I hope we stay connected, and I hope you all continue to support the LA Fellows program. I have to say, you gave me more than I can imagine, but I gave that to you. So, this is it, the talk's over. So, I was thinking to myself that this celebration is kind of like another water slide. You know, at some point the water slide's going to end and we're going to be cast back into the Joplin pool. But I'll tell you this, I know where the pool deck is. Mm-hmm. I know where my pool chair is. And when I get there, I'm going to have myself a fresh market.